Hello. So nice to meet you at this daily motivational meeting, reading quotes from World Scriptures book. This is a very powerful quote that helping billions of people and will help you too. We are reading the book from the game. Please find all the chapters at our Message to Billions channel. And now let's read the next chapter. Very interesting topic. What about Buddhism? Father Moon has the highest respect for Buddhism, a religion that has deeply influenced the culture of his native Korea. He regards the Buddhist teaching and practice of self-denial is the summit of world religious teachings for recovering our true original self from the mind of our fallen condition. To reach that state of emptiness, what Father Moon calls the zero point, is true enlightenment. In Father Moon view, Buddhism is lacking two essential points, knowledge of a personal God and the full comprehension of the ideal of true love. Nevertheless, it was God who taught the Buddha and set up Buddhism to give light to the Orient. People of all faith can learn much from Buddhism, particularly about the way of self-denial to overcome false ego and uncover the true self. The value of Buddhism. The best of path is the eightfold path. The best of truth are the four noble truths. No attachment is the best of mental state, the best of human beings is the sage one. This is the only way, there is no other that leads to the purity of insight. You should follow this path, for this is what the bewilders Mara. Embarking upon the path, you will make an end on path. I have declared this path after having learning the way for the removal of thorns. Not by matter hair, not by family, nor by birth does one become a Brahmin, but in whom there exist both truth and righteousness, pure is he, a Brahmin is he. I do not call him a Brahmin merely because he is born a Brahmin womb or sprung from a Brahmin mother. Being with impediments, he should address other seer. But he who is free from impediments, free from clinging, him I call a Brahmin. He who realizes he is this world, that destruction of his sorrow, who has laid the burden aside and emancipated him, I call a Brahmin. He who has laid aside the cudgel in his dealings with the whether thin or strong, whom neither harms nor kills, him I call a Brahmin. He who is freely among the hostile, who is peaceful among the violent, who is unattached among the attached, him I call a Brahmin. And whom lust, hatred, pride, and detraction are fallen off like a mustard seed from the point of a needle, him I call a Brahmin. Even ornament royal chariots wear out, so too the body reaches old age, but the Dhamma of the God of good grows not old, does do the good, reveal it among the good. What is causal happening? Conditioned by rebirth is decay and death. Whether breath and there be an arising of takatas, or whether there be no such arising, this nature of things just stands, this casual status, this casual orderliness, the relatedness of this to death. I pray homage to perfection of wisdom. She is worthy of homage. She is unstained. The entire world cannot stain her. She is a source of light, and from everyone in the tribe world. She removed darkness and she leads away from the blinding darkness caused by defilements and by wrong views. And here we can find the shelter. Most excellent are her works. She makes us seek the safety of the wings of enlightenment. She brings light to the blind and brings light to death. All fear and distress may be forsaken. She is the mother of the Bodhisattvas and account of the emptiness of her own marks. As the donor of the jewel of all the Buddha's Dhamma, she brings about the 10 power of Buddha. She cannot be crushed. She protects the unprotected with the help of the 4 grounds of self-confidence. She is the antidote to the birth and death. She has a clear knowledge of the own being of all Dhamma. For she does not stray away from it. The perfection of wisdom of the Buddha, the Lord, set in motion the will of the law. Father, let's read the quote from the Second Coming Messiah, Father Sun and Moon. In ancient times, Buddhism and Buddhist culture emerged out of God's will in order to reform the society of India. Buddhism presented a new ideal through a new understanding of subject and object relationship. Buddhism, which emerges from India, is a world-level teaching. Only religions like Buddhism, which transcend the practical domain of life and contains a world-level point of view and transcendent philosophy, will remain in the last days. Among the oriental religions, Buddhism is the closest to God's providence. However, as Buddhism teaches the logic of Sarvadharma, the ones of all things, it is important of a personal God, a major weakness. Nevertheless, God set things up this way to prepare the people of Asia to one day be united with God's kingdom through the oriental religions when Buddhism would connect with Judaism, had they later received Christ. Buddhism teaches the existence of God, but it focuses on God's lawful aspect. It does not explain that God is actively working in the world. The Buddha's entire philosophy is based on law, karma. And however, the object of dharma is the circumstances of human beings as object, not the human beings itself. Actually, the measure of human beings is love, not law. But the Buddha taught the standard based on law. Hence, his teachings are called Law Sutras. Buddhism teaches self-realization, but what should happen after attaining self-realization is that the end of it. And that is why even though Buddhists live solitary, live deep in the mountains and work hard for self-discipline and self-realization, they still are ambiguous about the ideal world of love. So powerful quote for today. Please watch on more time this video if you have difficulties. Today, share this video as we end this billion happy life subscribers marathon. Contact me for consultation, cooperation, and to become a member of this Heavenly Parents Holy Community globally. Stay happy, healthy. Wish you a great, blessed day. See you tomorrow, same time, same place. All the best. Bye-bye.